I gotta see what this chick is all about, man. I keep hearing about it. I heard that one song, What a Shot Hate. So let's see what they got going on with this chick, man. Let's see what's the big deal. Gorilla pimp. Please have a good flow.
I've been going up so night, bitch, trying to come for me. But they ain't stopping shit. I still be popping out so comfortably. I get up in there most sometimes where I don't want no company. And shit us on my mouth right now, but getting to this money, G. I'm a young ass bitch, but I still like my niggas old as hell. I just got some time for my dude out because I'm bold as hell. You can't fix your
this shit whack as come on, son. Glorilla. Y'all know who that is, right? That's that chick who got that song, that one song that's out that all the chicks is going crazy over. It's catchy, though, this song right here. I know y'all heard it already.
I'm finna break out right now.
This shit is catchy. This shit is number 14. I like to see when a chick make it, you know what I mean? I'm not hating on the fact that she made it, but she's kind of corny to me. But I get this song. This song is mad catchy. I get it. Trust me. This is like a, you know, chicks like these type of anthems, like, you know what I mean? They love these type of anthems. These bitches look dirty as fuck.
I'm F-R-E-E, fuck
oh
nigga
my god.
Free. That mean I ain't gotta worry about no fuck nigga cheat. And I'm S-I-N-G-L-E.
She gotta be from Memphis.
L-E again. Y'all find hanging out the window with my wretched ass friends. I'm F-R-E-E, fuck nigga
terrible
look.
Oh my god. I paused the video on the wrong spot. Hey, let me look. Let's get a good look at these bitches. Sure, the pregnant chick with the missing edges. But this is what it is in the hood, though. I don't think she knew that this would do what it do. But I'm happy to see anybody make it. You know what I mean? I just hope they don't, you know, influence my daughters to do no dumb shit. But welcome back to episode 154 of the Old Joker Side Podcast. I'm your host, Will Mills, a.k.a. King Dirtbag. What's good, everybody? I am back once again. I'm all recorded out. I've been going crazy with this recording shit, but now I'm back on track. I'm in order. I'm recording a little later than I like to do during the day, but I am recording so I can get one in the bag, and I want to make sure I keep my shit consistent. You know what I'm saying? I'm trying to stay consistent with it. Doing everything by myself for the past couple of months, it weighs down. So, you know, I kind of miss having an engineer where he took care of the audio. I took care of the audio. He took care of the visual work because I don't know if any of you guys are familiar with editing. It ain't easy. You know what I mean? I mean, now the editing part of it is easy for me. Like, I know how to do it. But the time, it's a job in itself. So, but I mean, I'm pretty sure eventually when I get, I mean, I like collecting this money by myself, to be honest with you. I like the benefit. And I know I'm a perfectionist, so it's going to come out the way I want it to look. And the cool thing was about my old engineer moderator, me and him kind of like vibed. He understood what my vision was to a certain extent. So I didn't have to give him no instructions or nothing. But if you see now, if you look at the visuals before, of course it was a two camera shot. It's just me, so I don't need a two camera shot. But a lot of the graphics that's being added, he didn't do stuff like that before. So I kind of leveled up on him a little bit. You know what I mean? I mean, I'm pretty sure he could have did it if he wanted to, but you know. Shout out to him, though. Hope everything is good. Where we starting at today, y'all? Where we starting at today? Let's see. Hopefully, this is going to be a fun podcast. I do got a lot of fun shit on here. It might not be a longer one today, but we'll see. Y'all see me blowing this vape, right? So, they're attacking the vape market. They've been coming after the vape market. I believe they just banned Juul pods. Let's see what that's about. I believe they banned Juul. So for you Juul smokers out there, they banned them. They banned them. So let's see. Juul banned. All right, so. Okay, so this just passed. FDA lets Juul appeal ban stay on the market during a review. The FDA has suspended its order to stop the company from selling its vaping products. Okay, the Food and Drug Administration has decided to allow Juul Labs vaping products to stay on the market temporarily, citing scientific issues that warrant a review of the agency's ruling last month to ban the company's e-cigarettes. Now, I do understand why they would ban this. Now, the Juul pods, from my understanding, you can't regulate what's in it and what's not in it. Of course, the ingredients that's on the pack is included, you know, when you buy it, I guess. But I know each Juul pod contains 5 milligrams of nicotine, right? Let's see what cigarette, how many milligrams of nicotine is in a cigarette. Let's see. So each cigarette contains 8 to 20 milligrams of nicotine found in a single cigarette. Wow. With the average being about 12. All right. So if you get like a light, it'll be like an 8. And I guess like a Marlboro or some shit like that, I'll be the full 20. You know, strong ass cigarettes. This is my thing, right? I know, as a guy who vapes, I used to smoke cigarettes. I quit smoking cigarettes almost 10 years ago. And I've been vaping ever since. Let me tell you something as a former cigarette smoker. When you smoke cigarettes, first of all, it's extremely addictive, right? It was times I didn't have a cigarette, I would bug out. I would flip out on whoever around me. I needed my nicotine fix. I was like a crackhead over cigarettes. You know what I'm saying? And if I was broke and I ain't had no bogeys, I'll smoke whatever cigarette was available. Straight up. And of course, I'm black, so I was a Newport smoker. For vaping to be such a new product and them banning it, the FDA is going to ban it. First of all, the government can't regulate vaping. It's too new. But here's the thing, and I know a lot of you probably disagree with this, but I'm telling you as a person who's been vaping for almost 10 years, I weaned myself off of nicotine. Of course, when I needed a nicotine supplement, it wasn't the cigarette that got me. It was the nicotine contained in the cigarette. So I smoke a cigarette and I need my nicotine fix. So I moved over to vaping. First, before I started doing my own building, because this is a built vape. This is built. That's why I blow those so many clouds. See? This is a mod. You build these. You build your coils. Why I keep looking at the monitor instead of this camera? When I'm looking away, I'm looking up at the monitor to look at myself. But the camera, the monitor is on top of the camera. So for those who view me on YouTube. Nicotine in its pure form, your throat can't handle that shit. You know what I mean? Cigarettes is one consistent amount of nicotine. But when you smoke nicotine without all the tobacco and shit in it, just inside of a vaping products, inside of a vaping product, it's harsh. So I started out like a 12, which probably was equal to what I was smoking in a cigarette. After a while, your throat can't take those hits anymore. Pause. So you wean down to like an 8. Then your throat can't take the 8. Then you wean down to a 6. And then you wean down to a 3. A lot of people stay around 3. Some people jump down to 1.5. And then some people go to 0, like me. I'm on 0 milligrams of nicotine now. So now I'm 80-20. 80% vegetable glycerin and 20% Oh, God damn it. I'm sorry. I got to pronounce that word for those who are interested. Propylene glycerol. 20% propylene glycerol and then no nicotine. So pretty much I'm just vaping clouds. Just know the flavors that's in it. You know, my flavor I like now is peach pear, right? So this is what I'm vaping. You can literally vape all day long. It has no effect on your breathing. It has no effect on anything. Trust me, it doesn't slow me down. It's not smoke. It's not, you're not smoking, right? Now, this is with mods. Now, with Juul products, there is a certain fixed amount of nicotine in it, and you can't control what type of liquid you're putting in it, the amount, the smoke you're getting. There's one consistent thing on that. So I can see that throwing some caution to the wind. The reason why the FDA is trying to get rid of vaping is because it's working. It works. It is a... Check this out. How much... And I want to... And I like to go to the internet to show you. How much safer is vaping than smoking? Check this out, y'all. Vaping is less harmful than smoking, but it's still not safe, of course. E-cigarettes heat nicotine extracted from tobacco, flavoring, and other chemicals to create an aerosol that you inhale. Regular tobacco contains 7,000 chemicals, which are top toxic. Okay. Now, we're talking about, you cannot compare this to a Juul. Juul pods are fixed pods. You can't do anything about it. You got to just use the pod, whatever they give you. These, you build these, and you can regulate the amount of juice that's going in it. Vaping is 95% safer than cigarettes. 95%. You understand what I'm saying? Although, because it's so new, you can't regulate what the long-term effects of it is. Of course, the nicotine is unhealthy, and probably some of the products in it is unhealthy. But what I'm saying, as a person who used to smoke cigarettes, if I smoke a cigarette and then smoke a second cigarette and maybe get to a third, I'm winded. You cannot keep smoking. It literally does something to your lungs immediately. I'm telling you, I can smoke this all day, not put it down. It has no effect on my lungs, no effect on my breathing. None whatsoever. That's because I'm doing this. And I would advise anybody who does vape, who wants to get into vaping as an alternative to smoking cigarettes, get a mod. Learn the products. I've been doing this for a while now. If you guys want to email me, send me a message. You want some information on it, and you want to quit smoking, I'm telling you, I've got at least 7 of my friends that stopped smoking, and they're vaping now, right? So I've eliminated the nicotine. So it's 80% vegetable glycerin, which is extracts and vegetables and the flavoring. So I know exactly what's going into my body. I know exactly what it is. It's three ingredients and no nicotine. But the thing about it is the government makes so much money off cigarettes. If a product comes along and it works, and it's a healthy alternative to cigarettes, a healthier alternative to cigarettes, of course they're going to try to regulate that shit and get it off the market. Why not? They're not making no money. Why the fuck you don't ban cigarettes? You know why? Because the government make too much money. Cigarettes have been proven to be one of the deadliest products known to man, and they won't ban them. Ban cigarettes. You'll ban a brand new product that works, but you won't ban the product that you know have been killing people for God knows how long. But that's how the government works. You know what I mean? I remember I used to work at this company called Doctors Trust Vitamins. I wish I remembered the name of this product. They sold a product that tripled or quadrupled the amount of white blood cells in your body. True story. I forgot the name of this product. All of a sudden, we all get them, and it was the number one selling product. It was like $100. I think you got like 100 capsules, but it was working. Real shit, it was working. Like, people who had cancer, AIDS, leukemia, what's another one? Sickle cell, shit like that. They were taking this product, and it literally was saving their lives, tripling, doubling, quadrupling their white blood cell count. Some of them, you couldn't even detect the whatever disease they had in their body because of this natural herb medicine they had. We get a email or a letter or something from the FDA saying they're banning it. They're taking it off the market. I had so many customers call me literally crying. First, I had customers calling and ordering what was left, because what was ever left on the website, we was able to sell that and, you know, give them the rest, you know, what was left. But once that ran out, that was it. And they took that shit off the market. I had so many customers crying. It was literally saving people's lives. But I know how the government operates. I know how they operate. If you have a product that works and they can't regulate and get their cut, they will take that shit off the market. That's a fact. But yeah, so Juul pods are not banned. They're able to still sell while they have a pending decision in court. All right, so what else do we got on the list? Okay. This is about, oh, you know what? Let's talk about this shit. Did y'all see that fucking, that senator that was twerking for votes? I didn't see Senator Mack. Where's she from? I think New Hampshire. a black senator was twerking for votes on the beach. I see this video of her on her hands doing a handstand. Oh yeah, we got to watch this. Of course, it's a bunch of people just critiquing her. That I can't see the damn video. Where's the video? Rhode Island Senator Tierra Mack twerking for votes. Let's see. Let's check this out.
Vote Senator Mack.
What?
Tierra Mack, Rhode Island Democratic State Senator, is twerking to get some
Let's
votes.
Let's go back. Let's go this back. That was trash. She didn't even do a good job.
Vote Senator Mack.
I mean, she's not ugly,
Tierra
but...
Mack.
What was that supposed to do? Like, what was that supposed to do? What part is she gotta be? She gotta be Democrat. There's no way a Republican would do no shit like that. Let's look her up. Senator Tierra Mack. What is she? Senator Tierra Mack. Oh, so first thing popped up. Yo, they going in on her. Of course she's What did she say? Did she respond to this? Did she respond to this? I mean, if she having a good time and twerking, she having a good time. Cool. We need younger politicians in there to relate more to the people. I get it. But of course they're gonna write this off as saying she's twerking for votes because she said that shit. She should have left the voting part out. You know what I mean? It's not a good look. You know, it's not, regardless of what party you're in, it's not a good look to do that. If you're going to twerk, just twerk. Cool. You know what I mean? But don't twerk and then say, vote Tierra Mack. And you black. It's not a good look, sweetheart. You fucked up. That was dumb. Whose idea was that? That was stupid. Straight up. Remember who you are and what you look like, what you represent in this country. There's twerking is no good stigma around twerking. It's some chicken head bird shit. I love it. Actually, twerking is viewed as that in America. But twerking is actually a traditional African dance. And it's not, Americans have destroyed it. But original, it's the name doesn't come to me, but I'm sure I didn't. But the original name for it, it's a name for it. Twerking. It's a name for this dance. It's called the Mapouka dance. The dance existed for centuries, and the way they do it, it's amazing. So let's give y'all a little history lesson on twerking, okay? Because it came from, of course you knew it came from women with ass. So you know that, and that's why black women do it the best, okay? It's an African dance. Of course, it's been turned as anything black people do to have fun is ghetto. Because men are perverts and men sexualize everything. And a lot of times women sexualize it too, right? But it's not called ghetto when Miley Cyrus does it. Or any of these white bitches who can't dance, they try. I'm not calling them bitches because they're white. I'm calling them bitches because they're exploiting something from our culture, and they're exploiting it, and they're being viewed as heroes for it. And it seems fun when they do it. But when we do it, our women do it, they're viewed as ghetto. No, that's just dancing, having a good time. You know what I mean? But let's get y'all the oranges of it, right? The origins of twerking, where it all began. Twerking has been a part of black culture. It's only been in recent years that mainstream media began to acknowledge and accept it. The origins of twerking can be traced back to Ivory Coast in West Africa, where a similar style of dance known as the Mapouka dance was originated. The dance has existed for centuries and consists of a series of movements emphasizing the buttocks, Although not viewed as the same respect as dances such as ballet or tap, when done right, it requires tremendous skill and attention. Let's look at the, y'all need to see the way the African women do it. It's amazing what they can do with their bodies. It's just an amazing thing. It's similar to like when you, it's not, the dance is not similar, but when you see a woman do belly dancing, the way they can just move that one portion of their body, their pelvis, that shit is crazy. So check out the Mapouka dance. Here we go, let's check this out. Now these are the, this is the original. All right, this is. Now, come on, I want y'all to kill it, man. Y'all was doing it kind of trash. They go, damn. All right, so yeah, it do look, it is kind of sexy. Goddamn. Sheesh. That's real ass too. That's real African ass right there. It ain't no butt shots. That's real African ass right there. I gotta see another one of these. Hold on. Best African Mapouka dance. Let's check this out. Yeah. Make me wanna twerk. Let's see how they do when they walking. Look at that. There you go. That's when I saw them do it. When they walk, that shit is fire. That shit is fire when they do it while they walking. Nah, that ain't her real ass. That ass is crazy. No way. No, that's real ass. Wig is terrible, though. That wig is horrible. Come on, y'all. Get to it. God damn it. See some African ass shaking. Yeah. Come on, get to it, ladies. There we go. There she go. That's it. That's how you do it. That's how it's done. That's real twerking. Mapouka. That's what I'm going to call it. I'm going to say Mapouka for me, sweetheart. Come on. There you go. Now they getting up. Now they all going to do it. Look at that. That's ass right there. That's real. That's how it look. There you go. Woo! Get it. Get it. I wonder what they smell like, though. I'm not saying they stink, but, you know. I don't know if they take pride in, you know. You know what I'm saying? And not because they black, just because they're poor. But maybe they're not poor. Let me shut the fuck up. That shit is crazy. One of the worst things to see is like when a woman is twerking with a dress like that, and like you can see the wet, the coochie stains on the back of it. That shit is gross. But this is some pretty amazing stuff, y'all. So for those who care, this is, nah, that one right there is. Yeah. What you got for them, Meg? Nah, Meg is nice with it. So ladies and gentlemen, this is real twerking. This is the Mapouka dance from the Ivory Coast in West Africa. All right, it's not some ghetto shit. This is a real dance from Africa. It's been done for centuries, okay? So stop trying to play my people, all right? What else we got on the dock yet? And also, Senator, you know, twerk, have fun, but don't fucking twerk for votes. That's a little nasty, sweetheart. You know what I mean? I wouldn't vote for you. Oh, look, she can twerk. Let's vote for her. That's like Kamala Harris when she came out with the Timbs on, talking about vote for me, bitch. Kamala Harris, first of all, you had the wrong Timbs on. You had them choked up. You had the buck nakeds on. You ain't had the double sole joints. You was out there with the beef patties, with the buck nakeds, single sole Timbs, choked up. You wasn't even wearing them right. So if you were trying to relate to us, that ain't it, sweetheart. And your feet wild big too, so that didn't work. Now, if you had them on just for what they was for, but I noticed you try to do a lot of pandering. You know what I mean? Try to show things you relate. When she showed up at the worst shit she did was when she showed up at the verses for Brandy and Monica. Like, make sure you guys get out and vote. Do you care about us voting, or you care us voting for you? That's why I don't fuck with Democrats, I'm telling y'all, man. I would do independent, but, you know, I've been rocking with the Republicans for a minute now. I don't care what nobody think. I rock with the Republicans, you know what I mean? I'm over there. Anyway, let's go. Okay. This right here. I gotta show y'all this. Check this out, y'all. Where's the video? Come on. Don't do this to me. A preacher said some wild shit. Okay, so this white preacher, I'm gonna tell you what he said about homosexuals. Sure. They took the video down, but I'm gonna find it, y'all. I gotta find it. I gotta find this video for y'all because he's wild, and of course he's under fire for what he said. All right, here he is. Check this out, y'all. Steadfast Baptist Church, Texas.
Watauga have a and of course history he's from Texas. Gay rhetoric, and that continued on Sunday when Pastor Dylan Oz gave a statement calling for the execution of gay people. This is audio from part of that sermon.
Check this out, y'all.
They should be convicted in a lawful trial. They should be sentenced with death. They should be lined up against the wall and shot in the back of the head. That's what God teaches.
Protesters showed up outside the church.
And this is the problem with religion, y'all. I might piss a couple of people off, but I'm going to say it. All religion is bullshit. All of it. Because it's man-made. Every last one of it. The Bible does condemn gay homosexuality. I know some gay people who are religious. Why? I understand believing in a higher power, being spiritual, being at peace with yourself and believing in a higher power. But how the fuck are you a Christian when the texture that's a product of that religion teaches to hate you? Why do you fuck with that? Black people, why do you fuck with the Bible, bro? Explain this to me. The Bible was given to us who are in America from slave masters. If slavery was the worst thing to happen to black people in America, and the Bible was given to us during slavery from the slave masters, why do you still connect yourself to it? You know why? Because it was our only sense, a source of hope. And I get it. Back then you were a slave. You didn't know what to do. There was no hope. And that book was the hope. And that's what we was talking. This was hope and obey your master and pray to white Jesus, all types of shit. That shit was beating our heads. And our grandmother's heads and our grandfather's heads. And they passed it down with a bunch of fear-mongering. Because that's all religion is. It's fear-mongering. It's telling you if you don't obey these rules, this is going to happen to you when you die. It's all fear-mongering. Oh, say your prayers or God is going to punish you. You know, say your grace before you eat. All this type of shit. And none of us ever question it. We never question it. Think about it. If you're a person who goes to church, did you go to school for theology? Did you yourself turn to Christianity for a reason? If you did that, cool. But are you a person who went because your mother made you go? And they scared you and spooked you into going, so you scared to speak out against religion? Because something might happen to you? You know why? Because you was taught that shit as a kid. You was taught the Easter Bunny, Santa Claus, Tooth Fairy, and Jesus. And you found out later on all the other ones, all those was fake. But Jesus, you held on to that one because that's the only one that they still practice. When your parents still believe that shit, you believe it too. I believe in a higher power. I found myself to be very spiritual, but I also found myself to not believe in none of this religion shit. None of it. You know what I'm saying? I'm an African. My blood is in Africa. That's where my roots are. My people didn't practice that. Now, if you go back to the ancient Egypt textures. I don't want to get into this shit. Fuck it, let's go. We there already, right? If you go back to Egypt, what Egyptians studied, They studied what we can see, and they made symbolisms of it, right? If you look at everything about Egyptian shit, astrology, 12 symbols, 12 disciples. I mean, 12 zodiac signs, 12 disciples. In the middle of that is the sun. Jesus, the Son of God. You understand what I'm saying? The Son of God. It's all about astrology, math. So when you put things into characters, it gives children a better understanding of it. Even if you look at the Ankh, the cross is a ripoff of the Ankh. The Bible teaches power of man. In Egyptian texture, they teach how powerful the woman was, how important the woman was. The Ankh represents fertility, a woman. The cross represents a man. So they just remove women from it and just trade it off one for the other. If you look up the story of Horus, the story of Horus and the story of Jesus Christ. All right. For instance, the story of Horus precedes the Bible by 5,000 years. And we have proof of that in hieroglyphics. The story of Jesus is almost identical. I'm just playing this for y'all, and you guys come up with your own based off what I'm saying. And this is the arrogance of Christians, right? When I start talking this shit, right? And I get into it a little bit. I'm not getting deep into it. I'm still trying to podcast, and I don't want to go off on the tangent on this. But when I talk to people who's Christians about this type of shit, they say, oh, you're an atheist. You see the arrogance of Christianity? Because you don't believe what they believe, that means you don't believe in God at all. I didn't say I'm godless. I said I'm spiritual. I believe in a higher power. I believe in good energy. I believe in karma. Why do I got to put a name in a religion? Why I got to attach that to it? You know what happens when you become a part of a religion? You become closed-minded. You become a part of a group. Because if you look at Islam, Buddhism, Taoism, Judaism, if you look at all of those religions, there's beauty in all of them. It's beautiful what a lot of these people think. Islam, that shit is beautiful. The discipline that they have, praying all of those times a day, not eating all day long, fasting regularly. Buddhist. If you look at the monks over there in Tibet, they don't believe in hurting anything. The fucking roach came crawling across, they laid there, let it rock. But they pray to a statue. And the Bible says you can't worship an idol. But you mean to tell me these people who don't know who Jesus is, who pray to a statue and won't even hurt a fly, eat good, treat their people good, love each other, best people in the world. You mean to tell me they doomed to go to hell because they don't read the fucking Bible? Come on, man. That's bullshit. Make it make sense to me. If you read the Bible to be a better person and to become one with God, cool. I'm not knocking nobody who's into religion because religion does make a lot of people better people. But a lot of people I know, these fucking preachers, ask tithing and all of this bullshit that goes on in church, that's what turned me off from it. But they call themselves shepherds of the Lord and shit like that. I can't deal with that, man. So I decided to tie myself away from it. But I want y'all to see this. The story of Horus. I want y'all to see this. I need a short one. All right, who is Horus? Okay. Horus and Jesus. Similarities. There we go. Check this out. Jesus versus Horus. Check this out.
Was Jesus based on the Egyptian god Horus? Many mystics claim Jesus never existed. It was just a copy of the deity Horus. They claim there are several parallels which prove this, such as Horus was born of a virgin Isis on December 25th in a cave. A star in the east announced his birth, and he was visited by three wise men. He had an earthly father named Seb, which translates to Joseph. He was baptized by Anup the Baptizer. He had 12 disciples, he performed miracles, like walking on water, and raised El Osiris from the dead. He gave a sermon on the mount, was crucified between two thieves, buried for 3 days, and was resurrected. He was called Christ, Anointed One, the Way, the Truth, and the Light, Messiah, Son of Man, and many other titles that are applied to Jesus.
Y'all gotta watch this. Y'all gotta watch this. Y'all gotta watch this movie called Zeitgeist. Watch that movie called Zeitgeist. It'll give you a real. It'll give you a better understanding of what I'm talking about. But moving along, see, when I get into that, it gets too deep. This was a funny story. And this will only happen in Florida, y'all. Check this out. This will only happen in Florida, where I live currently. Yo, why are they taking down all the videos? Oh, come on, man. Y'all gotta have it. All right. Chicken killer. Let's see. It gotta be here, y'all. Chicken killer. I gotta find this video because this was hilarious to me. It sounded like some South Park shit, y'all. It's some. Let's see. Chicken killer, Florida. These two neighbors had the most hilarious exchange. Here we go. Check this out, y'all.
Get ready for this story. A Florida man is speaking out after a month in jail. He's accused of killing his neighbor's rooster. He says the rooster attacked him, and he was wrongfully imprisoned. But his former friend says that is not the case.
I didn't know to give it a 21-gun salute, CPR, mouth-to-mouth, you know, or call the chicken ambulance.
Big Roo was Jason DeFelice's pet rooster. That is until James Nix hit it with a stick.
So I'm defending myself. You know, I was feared for my safety, and the chicken, you know, died.
Nix says the rooster attacked people.
I have not heard that, because I know the neighbor here.
Yo.
I know him. Like, we're friends. He never said anything to me about it.
Bro.
I did tell him, after the chicken hit my dad, I said, hey, man, the chicken attacked my dad. Oh, what's it do? It's just a chicken. What's he gonna do? You know, okay, well, look.
He says the rooster followed and attacked him.
His neck flares up, and he's doing his thing, and he's trying to jump up at me. And I try to hit it, but the chicken's jumping up at me, and I accidentally knocked it in the head. You know, call it a lucky shot, whatever.
But when Dave Felice came home, all he saw was his rooster dead in a ditch.
I said, I'm calling JSO. I called JSO. JSO didn't do nothing.
They locked him up. He went to jail for a month for this shit.
Animal control.
And in late June, James Nix went to jail for animal cruelty.
That's crazy.
Next thing you know, he calls the chicken police on me. Chickens are dying every day, people, at churches, Popeyes, and Kentucky Fried Chicken.
Nah, dude.
Really?
Nah, dude is that dude.
While the neighbors continue this very important fight, Nix says he never should have been arrested in the first place.
What did we just see?
He had a point, right? I mean, chickens.
What just happened?
But that poor neighbor lost his.
Now that's some bullshit, though. They shouldn't have locked homie up for that, man. They definitely shouldn't have locked homie up for that, man. Come on, man. Now the shit Caesar from Black Ink did, I talked about in the last episode, definitely locked him up. He's tripping. But roosters are violent. They got cockfighting shit. But that's the thing. They trailer park trash, so they don't even got no camera, so he could back his story up. But hitting a chicken, come on, man. Just let the name buy. How much a chicken cost? A live chicken. $10? Let's see. How much does a live rooster cost, y'all? It can't be that much. How much for a live rooster? Let's see how much a live rooster costs. $50. Look, the cost depends on the kind of rooster. It could be as low as $10 and as high as $1,500. Most individuals are willing to spend $10 to $100 on a rooster. $50 probably. $40 he probably would have paid. Come on, man. That man did 30 days in jail for that? That's crazy. Only in Florida, though. Moving on. Speaking of Florida, I got to bring this up, y'all. I have to. I told him I would because I want to humanize my friend. I spoke on my boy, Lawrence Doherty. You guys probably have heard the story. He is accused of killing former NBA star. Every time I get to this part, I forget this man's name and I feel like shit about it. Every time, man. Every time I want to say his name. Every time I get to this part. God damn it, his name just slipped my mind. What the fuck is wrong with me? He used to play for the Orlando Magic, NBA star killed. What the hell? I apologize, y'all, but I forgot this man's name. I do all the time. Damn, I really forgot this dude's name. Rest in peace. Adrian Payne, my bad. Adrian Payne. Okay. So, my friend has admitted to taking his life. He was arrested on first-degree murder charges. The charges got dropped down to second-degree murder. And then the other day, I get a FaceTime call. And it was him. And I said, what the fuck, bro? First of all, how did you get out? Did you escape? He had long dreads. His dreads are gone. So he's out on bond. And I'm not going to talk about the case on the show. But it's looking way different than the media presented it. And he's out. So when you're able to get bond on a murder that you admitted to, it looked like it's bending in your favor. That's what it always looks like. Because if you are released on a murder charge with conditions and you got a bracelet on your ankle, cool. He's out. I mean, the charges are not dropped yet, but he's out. He's on bond and he's out. He can roam around freely. He don't have no conditions to where he can't see his children, none of that. He's out. So whatever the media will twist things around without details. Because I remember when they first put the story out, they said that Adrian was in a car with his mother. That's not true. So a lot of things they said that wasn't true. A lot. And we're going to see how it plays out. Like I said, rest in peace to Adrian Payne. From what I heard about him, he was a good dude. Definitely a situation that should have been avoided. And at the same time, my friend Lawrence is a good guy. And shit happens where people feel like they need to defend themselves and they got to do what they got to do. Once again, Lawrence is 5'7", 5'6". Adrian Payne was 7 feet tall. So, and it happened at 2 o'clock in the morning in front of Lawrence's house. And when Lawrence got home, Adrian was sitting out there in front of his house. And whatever happened from there, the details will come out. So just those are the deets. You know what I mean? But moving along. Where we going with this? Got a couple more things I want to talk about. Let's get into this, right? So y'all heard about that piece of shit that killed all of those people on the 3rd of July, and I believe that happened in Chicago. Another mass shooting under the Biden administration. So this is what Fox News says. This is what she says.
Watching for answers and accountability. These are the eyes of some of the mass killers who've reportedly been regular pot users. Look at them.
Y'all gotta go back. Y'all gotta hear this again.
And in the media.
Y'all gotta hear this again. Y'all heard correctly. We back on this again? This is some 80s Nancy Reagan shit. That theory. With the fried eggs. We blaming it. Listen, let's go back.
Of some of the mass killers who've reportedly been regular pot users. Look at them. Those in politics and in the media who devote their time and energy to fear-mongering on fake issues while covering up the truth about the growing scourge of violent psychosis in our young people, they have to be called out, they have to be defeated, and then the public has to be educated. And parents, this means you need to get into the game. This means you understanding that this can happen to you, to your family, no matter how wealthy you are, how well-adjusted you are, how mature and together your children seem. It's time to call out the phonies and call in the warriors for common sense. And that's the angle.
Okay, let's get this idiot some common sense. Let's. First of all, she's blaming that on weed, guys. So let's go back to the image she showed of the killers. You know what I see? I don't give a fuck what one of their nationality is. I see four white guys. That's what I see. Let me tell you something. I've never smoked weed in my life. Never. I'm lying. Smoked one time when I was 16. Took three pulls, got paranoid, and never did it again afterwards. Never. You mean to tell me weed can make people become mass shooters? Weed. Social media can. Technology can. I'll even give you video games. Fuck it. Video games could do it. Weed, that's your angle, bitch. That's your angle. I don't smoke, and I am considered the oddball. You know what that means? Everybody smokes weed. Everybody. Like I said, I don't know anybody who don't smoke weed. I know a couple of people who don't smoke. Most black kids in the hood smoke weed. Have we ever had a black teenage young mass shooter? I remember being one black. I remember the one black dude who went on a fucking rampage. He didn't kill nobody. But the dude on the train not too long ago, the older black guy, and he allegedly did it. I mean, we don't hear much about that anymore because nobody died. The dude on the train to do a smoke bomb, I think he shot one or two people and was bugging out on the train from he came from like Seattle and went to New York and was on the train and shot a couple of people. We had the DC sniper who was the dude with, with PTSD. And I don't know if we've seen any more black mass shooters. But mass shooters who just shoot innocent people are 98% of the time white. All black kids smoke weed. So are you just saying like this affects white guys and then they smoke weed and they become mass shooters? Because if this was the case, every fucking body would be a mass shooter, miss. Everybody in America, everybody smokes weed. I'm pretty sure there's a very high percentage of people who smoke marijuana in this country. Teenagers. And no black kids are becoming mass shooters. So that angle is nuts. That is the first time I've, that's the first, that's an 80s angle. Is that Laura Ingraham? Is that Laura Ingraham? Fuck who she is. That's the dumbest thing I've ever heard in my life. That's up there. That's a reach. And nobody's going to buy that because, come on. You know what I mean? Fake. Stop. That's crazy. What do we got? What do we got? I don't got much more, but I do have one thing I wanted to discuss on here. All right, so Jazzy. I think her name is Watch Jazzy on YouTube or Instagram. She fine as hell, though. And I know she had two pages. She had a ghetto version of herself. And then she had the regular version. Jazzy Cam? No, that's not. Jazzy Brown is her name? Yeah, Jazzy Brown. Yeah. She's gorgeous too, by the way. So she did a video talking about, she was on a podcast and she had this to say. First, she was talking about how much she loves pleasing her men. And I think a lot of people talked about that. She was saying how her biggest flex is pleasing her, the way she treats her men. You know what? Matter of fact, let's listen to that one because I did enjoy that one. Pleasing her man. All right. She said her biggest flex is pleasing her man. Where is that? This is why I hate looking for shit. I should have found this, man. Oh, God. What is that? See, I should have downloaded the video. I wasn't planning on playing this one. But I am now. Jazzy Brown on pleasing her man. All right, just got to be it. Come on. All right, let's look for it.
When you genuinely care about someone's rest and you care about if they eat, I think that that's just, I don't feel like it gets more submissive than that, where it's like you're taking yourself out of it. But like, as far as like the closest love I think of having a child is like the love I feel for my partner. And it's scary for me to think that it'll change once I have the child.
So in your romantic partnership, you baby, you are a servant to, you are a lover, you want to be a step ahead. Why are you laughing?
These are your words. Because it sounds insane. Because I know it is my words, but it sounds crazy.
This is music to my ears. This is music to my ears. So I like that. I like that she said those things. So you heard some of the things she said, the way she treat her man. I love it. And obviously, I hope in her relationship it's being reciprocated. Because if you're just doing this shit and it's not being reciprocated, then that's corny. I saw a lot of women get mad about it. It's like, yo, you don't know how he treat her, though. But she's not there to talk about how he treat her. She's talking about how she treat him. That's the problem with a lot of women nowadays. Y'all only do it if you're getting it back. It's like, you'll reward him by treating him good if he treats you good first. So you coming in you're not coming in with the intentions on just being a good woman. I'll be a good woman if you're a good woman to me, good man to me. Why you can't just be a good woman? Why the fuck you need to make sure he's a good man first? If he turns out to be a piece of shit, leave him. But you should always come in with the intent on being good to your man. It shouldn't have to be earned. You should just be that way. If I gotta earn you to be good to me, I'm not fucking with you from jump. I'm not earning shit. You know what I mean? Just like when a person says, oh, you need to earn my respect. No, I don't. Nobody has to earn my respect. Nobody. Everybody, you can earn the loss of my respect. You can earn that. But you've done nothing to disrespect me or to not get my respect. Everybody gets my respect from the moment I meet them. Most people get my trust to a certain extent from the moment I meet them. You didn't do anything to not merit it. But as far as respect is concerned, you get that out the gate. If anybody ever tells you you got to earn their respect, walk away from them. That's a disrespectful motherfucker. So I like that she said these things. But this part of it bothered me. Let's see if it comes up. Maybe they didn't delete this portion of the video. Okay, check this out. Come on, no ads. Just play the goddamn video.
Anything goes for sure if you're comfortable with the person. Because I'm doing shit I never did before. I'm just like, I would have never done this. But you know what? I'm comfortable with this person and I feel safe.
Do you have an example?
Anal. You're like, you have an example? Yeah, that.
I'll continue. I'll let it keep going.
Do you do it for you or do you do it for them?
I do it for him because for me, I'm not at a place where I like it yet. We had one.
That's my problem with this. I don't understand how some men want anal, bro. Like I've done anal with a woman probably 2 or 3 times in my life. And each time it was because she wanted it. Now, Here's my thought process as a man when I hear about men wanting anal. First thing that comes to mind is he's gay, closet homosexual, right? But then I'm like, you know what, that's a bit harsh, right? So here's my scenarios that I created to where it's feasible for a man to want anal from his woman and it's not gay. One, you're on drugs, right? You're high, you're on drugs, you want to wild out. I get that. Two, you ain't the pom pom get extra wet, or the pom pom is extra dry, and you need to get your shit off. And her box is trash. Well, wet pom pom is not trash, but wet pom pom, if you don't have a certain size meat, you ain't gonna do nothing with it. Your shit gonna be slipping and sliding all over the place. You ain't got enough girth. You're gonna get drowned out of it. So I can see you getting fucked over. You could be emasculated by that. So you're like, you know what? I'm going to throw it up in her ass so I can make her feel something. I get that too. You know what I'm saying? It's a weak dudes out there. Like, I get that too. But the number one reason I can see a guy doing it is because the woman wanted to try it out. Oh, I left out one. You guys were together for a very long time. You've done everything. So you know what? Let's wild out. Let's try some new shit. But their relationship is pretty new. And she's bad. But that don't mean she got good box. Her box could be trash. Respectfully, Cam Newton. I'm not, you know what I'm saying? I'm not judging, but she's gorgeous. I don't see a man wanting to go to that hole. You know what I mean? Like, why? Like, pussy's amazing. There's nothing that feels better than that. Like, how could you go to an asshole, bro? That shit is crazy to me. That shit is crazy to me. Like, I'm telling y'all, the only way I've done that is if the woman be like, you know what? I want you to put it in my butt. Like, I'm not doing that. That shit is gross. First of all, the couple of times I did do it, like, it's preparation. First of all, she had to take a couple of dumps as much as she possibly could for the day. Because, check this out. My kids, my babies, I've had to put suppositories in them when they were constipated. And a suppository is very thin. And you put it up there, I guess it does what it does, and the shit come right out. Most meats, I would hope, is at least thicker than the suppository. So you putting up something in that butt that don't belong up in there, something going to come up out of you. That's one of my fears. Like, damn, this bitch going to shit on me. So she got to prep. She got to get comfortable. It's an unpleasant experience, like, for both parties involved. I could see it smelling like shit in the room. Like, come on, bro. You know what I'm saying? But anyway, that's my first problem with it. I'll get into my second problem with it.
Successful time where I was like, okay.
All right, let's start over.
Anything goes for sure if you're comfortable with the person. Because I'm doing shit I never did before. I'm just like, I would have never done this. But you know what? I'm comfortable with this person and I feel safe.
Do you have an example?
Anal. You're like, you have an example? Yeah, that.
Do you do it for you or do you do it for them?
I do it for him because for me, I'm not at a place where I like it yet. We had one successful time where I was like, okay, you know, my butt creamed.
Oh!
I was like, oh, shit. Like, it was like creaming. I don't know what the fuck that was, but it was
that
like.
That was doo-doo! That was doo-doo!
That in particular because yeah. Your butt doesn't lubricate in that way. It would. You could shit so on the person.
So it was booty juice. It wasn't, though.
It was clear.
Yeah.
That was shit, sweetheart.
I'll have to get back
to you. Nah, you didn't hear what Shorty said? Hold on.
Yeah, I don't know the science of that in particular because yeah. Your butt doesn't lubricate in that way. You could shit
so
on the person.
So it was booty juice. It wasn't, though.
That was doo-doo, Jazzy.
Yeah.
It was doo-doo for sure.
I'll have to get back to you on that.
This is gross.
Then does anal become an act of submission because you're letting your partner do something to you that doesn't necessarily feel good for you, but you know that it feels good and maybe powerful.
It is submission.
I think it feels more powerful for them than it feels good because you're getting nowhere. It hurts. Mm. It's like, okay, like if he wants
to, but he can still orgasm from it.
I think it's just the butt is just so tight and so untouched. And I think it's the fact that nobody's been in there but him is like the power of that. Like, that's my asshole. Like, ain't nobody been in that shit but me. That shit's mine.
Do you get pleasure because you're giving him an experience?
No, I actually like a finger in the butt.
No, from, like, anal in particular.
That I do regularly. That I do regularly. I don't have no problem hitting it from the back, you know, licking up that thumb. And you know what I mean? A little rim job while I'm getting money. You know what I mean? I'll do that. I do that. That's one of my moves. You stealing my moves, Ken. That's one of my moves.
If you're like, it's not my favorite thing, but I do it because X.
I think I just do it because he wants it. And I think like when you come to me in a space where it's like you're very masculine and it's just like, give me that ass. Or however you say it to me and you're like, ooh, like, I like that shit. Like, tell me what the fuck to do. Tell me what to do. I like to be told what to do.
She's dope.
You know even I mean? If the thing that they want you to do.
I don't want to do it. Yeah. That's traumatic too. I don't know. But like, because it's him. I trust him.
I guess
because
we have all these, like, and I hear when you're talking too, like.
Okay. Here's my ultimate problem with this shit. shut the fuck up, shorty. Like, shut up. Like, that's my biggest problem with it. If I was him, I wouldn't appreciate this shit. Because you see how I'm critiquing him? You know what I'm saying? Like, yo, bro, like this is what happens when you talk about what goes on in your bedroom on a podcast. I get it. She sounds beautiful doing it. She's eloquently putting it. She's being very respectful. Obviously, she loves a man. But certain things, zip it up, shorty. Like, if I'm there and we talking about it as a couple and I'm cool with this, fine. But I don't like that shit. Like, don't be telling my business I like fucking you up the ass and being dominant and you don't like it. Now when he tried at home, he gonna, like, does he know you don't like it? Now he know you don't like, it doesn't feel good to you. Yo, I would feel like a fucking monster. Maybe he like, but Cam Newton seemed like that type of dude. Like, he's real, I ain't gonna say alpha. He give off Hotep energy. You know what I mean? Like, Hotep, dominant, bitch, shut up. Like, he one of them guys. And that's cool. I rock with that energy. You know what I mean? I rock with that energy. I'm kind of like that, but because I have daughters, it's certain shit I can't be like anymore, because I just be imagining a nigga treating my daughter like that. And her bowing down. I don't need my girl on all fours walking around. I like a woman to tell me to shut the fuck up every now and then. Because your backbone, when a woman is your backbone, you know, she's your better half for a reason. Of course, you lead her, but at the same time, she can lead you too. Because, you know, regardless of how much money you got, the world is a tough place sometimes, you know? Shit get hard, and you be wanting a woman to say, get the fuck up. Get up. You better than this. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's, for me, like, sometimes men, we scared to go to the doctor to get ourselves checked out. One woman say, take your ass to the doctor. Go get yourself checked out. You want a woman to be that person. I don't want a woman bowing down to my every fucking move. I want you to be able to tell me what to do when I don't know what to do sometimes, when I'm lost. You understand what I'm saying? So I don't understand men wanting to be that dominant over a woman. I'm not saying Cam is, or she's that dominant or that submissive to him, but I can't have my woman being that submissive to the point to where she's not contributing to the overall outlook of the relationship. Like, everything can't always be about me. You know what I mean? That shit would turn me off after a while. Some fucking subservient chick bowing down. I don't know, man. And it could just be the women I was raised by nothing but strong-ass women who dominated the relationships. Listen, and that made me a dominant man, but it also got me accustomed to being more attracted to women who are a little more assertive. You know what I mean? You know, I consider myself alpha, and definitely I would want a woman who's also alpha, because the only thing that could conquer a, not, see, I'm using that word, fuck that. The only person who could conquer an alpha woman is an alpha male. You know what I mean? And that's a woman who's about her business, a woman who's dedicated to her man, but at the same time, she loves herself enough not to put up with bullshit. You understand what I'm saying? You could be submissive and still strong. A lot of women think because when they're strong and act like bitches, that makes them alpha. No, it doesn't. It makes you a bitch. You're a bitch. Like, you're not a nice person. You're not pleasant. You want a man to prove himself to you. You don't come in with that good energy. That energy she put out in the beginning when she was talking, I fucking love it. The energy she puts out, period, I love it. I love that shit. That shit is very attractive. But the fact that she talks openly about their sex life in the bedroom, to me, keep that shit in the bedroom. But much luck to them. I think they're a dope match, and I hope it work out. Last thing, and this is back to the women again, and another woman. Oh my God, this woman. When I saw her, first of all, she's drop dead gorgeous. Second of all, what she said in this video, man, women, y'all need to hear this. Y'all need to hear this. I know y'all gonna come with some rebuttals, whatever, circumstantial, but she said some real shit, and y'all need to hear this. Y'all need to hear this. Where's she at? Where is she? And I've seen her in other videos talking her shit. Is this it? No, that's not it. Where is it? And I'm gonna give my rebuttal on that. I know I just downloaded it. Where's the blood clot video? Come on. Hate this shit, y'all. I gotta come a little more prepared, but also this is a podcast. I'm doing this in real time. I don't edit nothing, so y'all wait. Y'all just wait. And you know what's crazy? I like scan through like my downloads area, and then I don't see the video, then I go through it, and then all of a sudden it appears. Cause I know goddamn well I downloaded that video right before I started recording. Cause I was supposed to talk about it in the last episode, but this is a timeless subject, so it don't even matter. To be honest, it don't even matter when I talk about this shit. Because what this woman said needs to be heard. Here we go. There she is right there. There she is. Talk your shit, queen. Queen, talk your shit.
So in regards to my last video, somebody said, so you'll never put your baby daddy on child support? And the answer is no. Let me tell you why. I'll never put my baby father on child support because I have to deal with this man for eternity. Okay? It's not just 18 years. Like, life doesn't just stop at that. No. Until I'm gone, he's gone, or the baby's gone, we have to communicate because I believe in family. So until one of those things happen, that man needs to be your friend. Now, I'm not saying you got to sleep with him, or you still got to be with him, or you got to follow his direction. No, but it pays to build a friendship with that man. And you can't build a friendship when you get the courts involved to put him on child support to make these small payments because you're low-key living off the payments. And some women aren't. They really support the child with the payments. But for the ones that don't, they collect the child support to be spiteful and to, you know, try to help maintain their life. I'm not built for that, okay? I would rather just work a little bit harder and deal with the headache of having to work a little bit harder or go a little bit harder than to put my baby daddy on child support. I'm not doing it. I'm not putting my baby father on child support. We need to be friends. And if you don't want to be here, if you don't want to be present, I'm not going to force you to be present. Yes. You don't want to be here? Well, shit, I don't either. I catch red flags real quick. So if I felt like at any point during the pregnancy or prior to you were giving me you don't want the baby vibes, I'm pro-choice. So we can, no problem. I don't believe in the, oh, the soul of the baby. No. You don't want it, I don't want it either. But I'm not putting my baby down on child support. No.
What's her name? Christina Mackey. Sweetheart, let me, you know, I'm late to the party on this, but I got to use it real quick. Let's give her the dirt round of applause real quick. Sorry, y'all got to wait on, I got to give her a round of applause. Come on with it. She got to get her round of applause. We got to give it to her. Gotta give it to her. I say this all the time, and this is me being a father of 6 children. The one baby mother who had me on child support, we do not get along. We will never get along. I can't stand that motherfucker. I can't stand her. And the child support payments were never that much. But the fact that she felt the need to go to the court and get them to try to regulate what I should pay for my kid was a slap in the face from the moment she did it. Because I'm not that guy. I willfully take care of my children. I don't need these white people in these courts dictating to me what the fuck I should and shouldn't be doing. She's never came to me and talked to me and said, hey, my daughter's grown now, but she never came to me and said, oh, you know, hey, I need this on these days, or I need this for the kid and that for the kid. It was child support. And granted, years ago, when I couldn't pay it and I was broke, I got arrested for that shit. And it ruined my shit. License gone. Passport gone. Income taxes gone. It took me years to catch up. And I had all these other kids to take care of, but my main priority had to be that one because I was bound to the court system because of it. Right? And you know when she took me off? When my daughter came to move with me. Because even with the child support payment, she couldn't fucking afford to take care of her. She couldn't afford to do it. So my daughter had to come to me anyway. So that's the only reason she took me off finally. But my daughter should have honestly been living with me years before that. But that's neither here nor there. We've always had a horrible relationship because of that's where it started, right there. Child support, I've always said it. Under certain circumstances, I get it. The only women that should be obligated to get child support are women who were formerly married. You were married to this man. And that's only because it should be court ordered is because marriage itself is a contract through a court. Right? Therefore, so is divorce. Therefore, child support goes hand in hand. You did all that shit through the court, you got to do it through that. That should be an obligation for a man if he divorces or she divorces, if they get divorced. Should be an obligation like that. Right? Secondly, in some cases, women do have to put the man on child support because the court requires for that man to be on child support if he signed a birth certificate in order for that woman to receive benefits. In the beginning of it, the woman needs to get Medicaid, food stamps, welfare in some cases. In order for them to give the child these things, the man has to be on child support. I understand that. But a lot of these broke-ass women will take advantage of the system and keep that shit forever. So here's the thing. You mean to tell me a man is obligated to pay court-ordered child support and a woman could take advantage of the system and not get a fucking job? You mean to tell me the baby's 6, 7, 8, 9 years old and you can't get off welfare? You can't get off food stamps? You can't get off child support? You can't get off get the kid some real insurance? You mean to tell me you could be a broke motherfucker forever, but this man got to bust his ass to pay child support? That's bullshit. That's bullshit. And in my situation, this motherfucker was married. So you mean to tell me y'all both broke on Medicaid, food stamps? Meanwhile, I got me and all my other kids to take care of, and I got to pay you child support, but you could be broke? I got all these kids, but you got one. But you can be broke. The system allows women to do that. Child support ain't nothing but a broke bitch sport. Period, point blank. At the end of the day, if you're not dating an NBA player, if you're not dating a man who makes six figures, you ain't getting shit in child support. You're getting nowhere. The most you're getting is maybe like, well, you get 30% of his pay. 30% if he has one child. But also, you got to take into consideration, the courts take into consideration what that man makes too. They take into consideration. Child support should stop after a while. It should stop. And another thing about child support, visitation is not tied to it. That means these bitches out here can fucking have a man on child support and not even let him see his kid. Happened to me. Trust me, I know. Paying all of this thousands and thousands of dollars in child support, can't even see my kid. And the mother will poison the kid against you so much that even when you are ready to see your kid and she want to let you see the kid don't even fuck with you because she done poisoned the kid against you. Trust me, been through it. Been through it. So your money, your fucking passports, your driver's license, everything is fucking ruined because this chick is allowed to be a bum through the system. Really? This whole child support shit need to be revamped. Granted, not on child support no more, been off for years. But the system is fucked up. And y'all women who run to the system to make this man do something, you're pathetic. That's a fact. Because you say, I don't need no nigga. I don't need him. Y'all shit don't work out. Take care of the kid by your fucking self. Take care of the kid by yourself. That's a fact. Because you ain't going to get nothing from him. You think that money, that your little bullshit money you getting is more important than the time? I don't remember nothing my dad did for me before he died. I remember the time my dad spent with me. The time. The money don't mean nothing. Y'all attach everything to this fucking money. If the man don't give you a certain amount of money, he can't see his kid. If he don't pay the child support. So you let the system dictate to you what your kid is worth? Your kid is worth $50 a week? That's what your kid is worth? Your kid's relationship with their dad is contingent upon him paying you $50 a week? A lot of dudes that don't pay child support is because they ain't got it. He can't have a hard time? He can't? He can't have a hard year where shit just hard for him? Where he can't find a job? You mean that man is not allowed, that man is not worthy of being a father because he lost his job? And even when he loses his job, child support's still held over his head. And if he can't pay it, he go to fucking jail. And if he can't pay it, they take his driver's license. The one thing he need to go to work. Ain't no hardship license for child support. Ain't no hardship. You know what there's a hardship license for? A DUI, murder, drug charges. They will give those motherfuckers their license back to get back and forth to work before they give a man who needs to take care of his child, his license. They will put you in jail for 6 months. Meanwhile, once again, that woman is allowed by law to be a broke, bum-ass bitch for 18 years. You mean to tell me this woman can receive child support benefits, Medicaid, food stamps? The government ain't gonna make that bitch get off her ass and go do something? But the man got to do everything and they ain't even together. And on top of that, visitation and child support don't go hand in hand. You go to court saying, yo, I'm paying my child support, but she ain't letting me see my kids. They tell you, oh, well, go to visitation court. Now you got to come out of pocket to pay. Child support system is bullshit. And you women out there that opt to put a man on child support other than try to build a friendship with him, to make sure he's a part of his kid's life, and your kid will grow with all this fucking resentment and hate towards their father, that's your fucking fault. That's your fault. If you need to go to child support because you need benefits, cool. I understand that. But if you're doing it to be a spiteful motherfucker because you feel like, oh, he should take care of this kid. No, he shouldn't. The baby was in your belly. You knew what type of nigga you was getting with. And even if he made a promise to you, it's more fulfilling to know you raised that kid by yourself. You ain't have no help from him. You cannot force a man to be a father. I'm sorry. You can't force him to do it. If you want to be in a kid life, you're going to be in a kid life. That little bullshit money you getting from him ain't worth it. Especially if he a deadbeat and ain't taking care of his kid. It ain't worth it. You shouldn't want nothing from him. You shouldn't want, oh, but it's for the baby. Bitch, please. That $50 to $60 a week don't make no fucking difference. Not in 2022, it don't. That shit don't make no difference. Man, I could talk about this shit for hours, man. But yeah, that's my views on child support system. I don't give a fuck how none of you women feel about it, how none of you dudes feel about it. Child support, ultimately, for the most part, is a broke bitch sport. Period, point blank. Because if you can't get up off your fucking ass after 2-3 years of being on child support and receiving benefits, and you ain't trying to get more money, you're a loser. You're a fucking loser. Period. If he's not allowed to be a loser, if he's not allowed to be a loser and he got to work and bust his ass, you should too. Fuck that. I know a lot of single mothers who do it. Go to school, work, and take care of kid with no help from the father. But y'all take advantage of the system and fuck that man's life up, and you fuck up the relationship between a child and their father with this child support bullshit. Knock it off. I said an earful. Anyways, y'all, that's going to do it for episode 154. Thank you guys for tuning in. Make sure you guys visit my website, kingdirtbag.com, for all the merch, for all the things I have to offer you guys. Make sure you guys follow me on Instagram at Will Mills, WILMILZ. Also follow my Facebook, Will Miller, and also follow my TikTok at KingDirtbag718. All right, till next week, All Jokes Aside podcast song done by Fredo Cash, Baltimore Stand Up. Let's get it. Whoa. Fredo,
I love that.
I love it. Whoa, me and Pyrex together, watch two worlds collide. Me and Jackie bought out the suites and we got hella whores inside. Whoa, I'm the shit, bitch, all jokes aside.
I'm the shit,
bitch, all jokes aside. Till next week, y'all, I will holler at y'all. Same time, same place.